In this video, I'm going to show you a Dropbox alternative, which starts with 5 GB for free. And when you refer a friend, you get 1 GB free per friend, up to 20 GB extra. We're going to dive in right now. As this business works a lot with referrals, I really appreciate it if you use my link. Go to wpressdoctor.com/sync. And press enter, or just click over here. This link, it will take you to the comments and the link and everything. All right. And then we are at sync.com, which gives you 5 GB free when you first sign up. Now, before we sign up, I gotta tell you something more about this company, because what's the difference between Dropbox is, for example, there's zero knowledge end-to-end encryption. Plus, all your files are not stored in the USA, but they are stored in Canada. And that makes a really big difference for security and also not selling all your information to third parties because of some kind of laws inside of these countries. Also, the pricing of this company is way better than Dropbox. You can get for individuals, for example, $8 a month for 2 TB, $20 a month for 6 TB, and you also have Teams, which is very useful to do. I'm gonna show you this later on. Sharing links is way more easier and has a lot more features than Dropbox itself. So let's sign up over here. We go up there, gonna fill in our email address and a really secure password and accept the terms and privacy policy and press create a free account. And here we are, welcome to Sync. Now, the next step is we can go to download it for Windows. So you click on this button and then start downloading the Sync installer to your PC. We're gonna install this in just a second. We're first gonna go to the web panel over there. Click on it. We're gonna sign in. The first thing I notice in here is it's way cleaner than the Dropbox interface or Google Drive or whatever. The only things you can see is an empty folder, and in here you have all these things. Now, how do you upload files? Well, you can just press on this upload button, or you can just drag and drop them to your web interface. I'm just gonna drop it over there. And now it starts uploading my intro to sync.com.mp4 file I've just recorded with this camera. Now, you might say this uploading doesn't go really fast. True, it's not because of sync.com, it's because I'm in Portugal and in this house, we don't have a fast fiber connection. Then you can upload even more, and of course you can also do this using the app. I'm gonna show you this in just a second. Now, then you can press close, and now we have our file inside of our sync.com cloud service. On the right side, we can upload it. We can also create a new shared folder, create a new normal folder, create a file, and you can also show your deleted files. Now let's create a new folder over there. I'm gonna call it and press on add right there. Now, if I just want to move a file into this folder, I can just drag and drop it in the Windows app, of course. In the web interface, you can drag and drop, but what you can do is click on here, go to move, and we're gonna move it into the sync folder. And there we have a folder. We're gonna move it. Now we move the file into this folder over there. What you also see when you click on move the vault. If I move it inside of my vault, I can also create new folders in there. Let's move it to my vault. Now, what is the vault? The vault is a very unique, special place, cloud only backup file. Everything you put in there will not be synchronized to your mobile phone, to your computers. It will only be synced within this web interface. And if I go over here to the vault, you can see my file being added into the vault over there. But also, when you need to archive things, you don't no longer need on your PC or on your device, just all put it inside of the vault and it's only there and not on your device. It's a real clever feature and I like this. When everything I moved into my vault is not in here anymore, it is in here. Fault. I can go into there. I can also go do it on my mobile app. And then I can also go into my vault, but it won't be downloaded to my device. But I can also remove it, go to move, and move it back to my sync folder inside of this folder. Move it. Here we go. Of course, sync.com works with all devices, your mobile, your tablet, your computer. You can sync your files across all these devices. Let's go and install our Windows app. We're gonna use an existing account. Press next, fill in your email address and your password, and we press next. It's gonna verify it. And then we can choose our sync folder location. Do you want it to be on your C user's info, the normal place, or do you want it somewhere else? Press browse and pick your location where you want this folder to be. Also, give this device a name. I'm here on my desktop computer and it's a Ryzen 9, so that's why I've called it that way. Just use a name that you can easily recognize your device when you're looking at all your devices. Press next. And here we go, registering new device. And the installation is complete. Now, press finish. I'm gonna show you how this works within Windows. Now, down here in the corner, you can see all my cloud devices. I have Dropbox, of course, I have OneDrive. I even have a G drive somewhere, but it's not synced right now. If we go to over here, we can see the sync icon there. And it has a check mark, so it means everything's okay. If you click on it, right click, then we see an interface that's really familiar. We can see the files that I've just changed around to get it into the folder. Here we can see the check mark which says we are in sync. That's great. But you can also go over here to the sync.com web panel and we can see the sync folder on our computer. And over here we have the sync desktop app settings. You can open your sync folder, go to the web panel, recently fetched files, events, the pausing sync, of course, preferences, help, get more space and quit sync. Now what I wanted to show you was the integration with Windows. And then we see over here, this is just a folder like your normal Dropbox folder over there. But then you can get in here and you see that this map is actually empty because it's in my vault. If I want to go into my vault, I need to go to the web interface over there, go into my vault, click on it and I press move it. I'm going to move it again to my sync folder, move it to this folder and I press move. Here we go. And then I go back to my folder in here. I'm gonna refresh this button. And then you can see this blue icon that something is syncing. As you know, my internet is not that fast here in Portugal. So, but then it's already there. Another thing I'm very excited about is sharing files with other people because it's a bit different than Dropbox. If I click on here and I go to share as link, I need to verify my account. So you go to your email and then we have received an email from sync.com asks us to verify our email address. Press this blue button. Your account has been verified. Log in again. Here we go. Now I didn't mention this before, but if you click on here, you get started bonus. You can get actually 1 GB for free just out of the box. And that's really easy to create. We only have to install it on another laptop. And then I have to share a folder with a friend. Create a secure link. We're gonna do this right now. I'm already happy. I want to show you how to create a secure link over there. It's pretty easy. Just go to your file and go in here and press share as link. Or you can go into your Windows app over there and right click on it, go to more options, go to create a link. When you hover over it, you can see share. You can click on it and press share as link. Use this one. And then you're gonna create an encrypted link like this. It's only possible to see for me right now. And I can copy this link or I can immediately send it to. But there is more. You can also go to link settings in there. And then you have more options. You can also set a password for your file sharing link. I've never seen that with Dropbox. And you can set a label, intro.sync.com. This out. And you can enable comments for authenticated users only, which are registered with sync.com. And you can enable enhanced privacy. Now that's cool. When you even upgrade your plan to a paid plan, there are more options to even configure. You can put in expiry dates, enable file requests. You can set download limits as a self-destruct. Only 10 people can download this and then it's over. You can preview only mode for document and images without downloading it. Email notification on link activity. When someone does something, you get an email. And you can see your download count stats. Press save settings. And when you go back now in here, you can now copy your link and just close it and I can send it to anyone I want. So let me show you how this looks when someone else opens it. So I go to in a private window and I'm going to open my link I've just created. And when it's a private browsing, I'm not logged in. So it doesn't have any cookies, it doesn't have anything. And here we go. Now we have to enter the password. Oh, I forgot the password. Let's go over there, go to manage link. And we go to link settings. Ah, this is the password. Copy it, close it. Go back to there, put in the actual password and press submit. Let's see what happens. It's my raw video I've just created for you guys. I can get some real behind the scene footage. All right, and from here we can just download it in there. Now we can download the file, and we can also add a comment. If I'm signed in, I can post comments to files so we can collaborate or anything like that. Talking about collaborating, what's also really great is that it fully integrates with Microsoft Office. One of the things that's very important, if I create an empty Word document and I go to save this, now I want to save this in my sync folder, and I just like Dropbox and OneDrive, I have it inside of here. But what I want to do is I want to copy it inside of this bar on the left side. How do you do this? Right click on it. I don't know the English word actually. This, I have a Dutch Windows because I am Dutch. I can fast access or something, just click on it. And then it's over here, sync. I can click on this one, and then I can create a new folder over there. And I'm gonna share my empty document. Press save. I can close this again, and on my web interface, I immediately get the Office document in there. Now I can share it, of course, share it as a link, but I can also open it. But if I want to work in the cloud or work directly with Microsoft Office, I press open. If I upgrade to Sync Pro, I can use Microsoft Office Online to integrate it, edit and view it and comment on it right from the cloud. It's really useful. And what about pricing? Here we can also compare everything about sync.com. So just follow some links on the website and you can see everything if it fits what you need. The question is, of course, how many files can you store? Well, it's basically limited only by the space. However, there is a hard limit of 100,000 files each folder, but you can create, of course, unlimited folders. Another question is, how many computers or devices can you connect to your free sync account? You can connect up to 5 active computers or devices. But if you, for example, have your partner which want to use the same sync folder, just let them create their own sync account. And then you can set up team shared folders to control with them. Excellent feature. Is there any size limit on the folders? Well, it says if you go higher than 40 gigabyte per file, then you will notice a slight decrease in performance. But there is actually no limit in file size. And of course, with every cloud storage system comes the going back to different kind of versions. If I now go to my office and I change this, and I save it again. And when I go into my folder in here, into my file, I can go to version history over there. And you can see that we have 3 different versions already. The current version right there, we have a other version, and we have the first version. What I also like about sync.com is, in the event of a ransomware attack and all your files got encrypted, you can just contact their service team and they will rewind your entire account, all your files, to a certain point in time. Now that saves you a lot of headache. Pro Solo and Pro Teams, you get 365 days of version history. So you have enough time to get the good version back in place. If you still have doubts about their security, go browse on their website, because they do have system and organization controls reports 2 and 3, and they're all validated by third parties. If you have any questions or you just want to say thank you, Matt, drop them down in the comments. I'll always reply. Hit that like button and make sure to subscribe, because I have a lot more viewers than subscribers. After that, check out this video, which has nothing to do with cloud storage. Absolutely nothing. I think.